I'm always amazed by how good lots of riders are to keep the bike stable in this section, because if you shut the throttle and go down a couple of gears and the back wheel starts to patter and judder out there. But what a lot of riders struggle with is putting things together. She's basically listening to me drone on. We're going to use visual aids now to try and help. So I've drawn this this simple diagram.
Yes.
Eyes on stalks.
You don't.
So let's go through this diagram in a little bit more detail. Essentially it's the same as the way I talked through it before, but this is actually giving you more of a visual reference of what we're talking about. And at this point here, it goes full gas to full brakes. Without question, the hardest bit of the whole job, really.
If
a bike will always turn into the corner
better on it.
You've got really three basic components. You've got
your brake.
That means trail braking almost doesn't exist.
They also
identify the timing of how and when they do things. In reality, in the real world, there's a million different sorts of corners that you have to deal with. Wanting to sit up and drive out, and you end up bouncing off the curbs coming out the corner. Always get off the brakes, keep the throttle closed. Now, at paddock here, it's a very track-specific corner, and is a really tricky corner to get right.
Mark a
point, you can brake late and brake hard. This bit's the tricky bit, because
what you've done.
Now, at Hawthorns, because of the incline, a good idea is to actually keep a couple of fingers maybe. As you obviously shut the throttle, you're going to be revving at a certain RPM. You change down the gear, at the same speed the revs go up.
And again,
is you've got a section, which I call section one, which is essentially just your braking.
Section.
Support on Patreon. And then you can get to see all of my online content as soon as it's published. Plus, lots of other private content made exclusively for my patrons.